Economic Strategies. Amend Republic Act Number 10844 or the law that created DICT to strengthen its regulatory mandates to cover emerging technologies and capacitating the agency to carry on research activities like the creation of regulatory sandboxes to enable it to better understand and manage such emerging technologies, not only AI, blockchain, and other emerging technologies. Number two, amend Republic Act 10173 or the Data Privacy Act of 2012 to provide the agency flexibility and agility to ensure that the protection of personal information will not be compromised by any emerging technology that will come our way. Number three, the use of any emerging technology, including AI, is expected to disrupt the job roles that we know today. Many jobs will definitely disappear, but emerging technologies will give rise to new jobs. What we need is a well-thought-of and effectively implemented national reskilling and upskilling initiative. Specific to AI, we need to capacitate our knowledge workers to be able to work with AI tools. Some countries, including ASEAN neighbors like Singapore and Malaysia, have publicly committed to investing huge amount of money in retooling their workforces on AI. Global collaboration, this was mentioned a while ago, AI doesn't respect borders today. International collaboration and AI regulation is crucial to ensure a level playing field and prevent a race to the bottom in terms of safety, standards, and innovation. Government funding for emerging technology research. We need to increase funding for universities and research institutions instead to accelerate breakthroughs in AI development and other emerging technologies. And lastly, public-private partnerships. Collaboration between the government and industry will foster innovation. Shared resources and expertise can accelerate breakthroughs and develop ethical frameworks for the application of emerging technologies, including AI. In closing, ATIN is committed to working with the community to continue work to navigate the different elements of emerging technologies to ensure their ethical application and development and balancing them with fostering innovation. Thank you very much, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Mr. Ibrahim. In other countries, how do they encourage, how do they set the ethical standards for AI? Meron na ba tayo? Meron na ba pong nagawa niyan sa ibang bansa?
Iba-ibang approaches, Mr. Chair. In the case of EU, they actually came up with the EU AI Act, okay? Which is, to many innovators, is actually very, it actually stifles OSIS innovation. In the case of Singapore, our DICT counterpart in Singapore just came up with ethical and governance frameworks initially, because they do not yet understand how AI is going to, where it is headed. Okay, this is actually being done in partnership, in collaboration with the private sector and industry. Okay, in the case of Malaysia, their focus right now is also to develop the positive ethical use frameworks and governance frameworks. However, they're very, very focused on making their workforce ready to work with AI. Kasi alam nila maraming mawawalan ng trabaho. So they're actually getting them ready to use AI tools. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, listening to Mr.
Ibrahim.
Mr. Ibrahim, it seems that, did I get it correctly that he has apprehensions about the employment of AI and this might affect the labor force in the country? Is that it, Mr. Ibrahim?
With due respect, Congressman Barbers, hindi ho ganun.
Okay.
My apprehension is if we do not get our workforce ready, then a lot of our a lot of them will actually lose the jobs. But AI will present new job opportunities, and we need to get our workforce ready to make this happen.
Yeah, that's exactly my point, Mr. Chair. The reason why I ask that question is because there are misconceptions and misapprehensions on the employment of AI. Akala kasi nila, when you have AI, this will reduce the number of workforce in different sectors or different industries, which is not, that's because if we have that kind of a result, as governments use AI, then perhaps this could have been pronounced already. Parang walang pinagkaiba rin yan dun sa paggamit ng internet. When first the internet was first introduced to us, we were all apprehensive. Sinasabi natin, ako, paano yan? Mawawala ng trabaho yung mga sekretary, mawawala ng et cetera, et cetera. Because it is something new that we all don't know what the effects would be. But in this case, governments are already using AI. And as appropriately stated earlier by Mr. Ibrahim, na borderless na ito eh. Wala nang, ano, that this is precisely the reason why this bill proposes the creation of an authority that would regulate and come up with a policy framework as to the deployment and ethical use or development of AI in the Philippines. Baka lang mahuli kasi tayo eh. That's the reason why we want this done, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Yes, Congressman Romano.
To share this to further what the Honorable Barber's mentioned, I think Mr. Ibrahim said na ang suggestion na ngayon, instead of this bill, is that we in fact amend certain other bills. Could we know why are you suggesting that instead of going for, nalingyo na sinabi ni Honorable Barber, ito naman is to create that council or committee to prepare the Philippines. In fact, sabi niya, upskilling, gagawin nga niya, yun ang plano nila, mag-upskill with the upskill, reskilling, para masigurado natin, prepare tayo. But why do you take the stand that instead of these bills, is that we just amend the data privacy, and amend two other measures? Ano yung pagkakaiba?
As highlighted in the privileged speech of the Honorable Congressman Mark Gold, AI governance remains a nascent space today and evolving so fast beyond our capacity to really understand what it is actually headed. Okay. He further emphasizes that proposing certain regulation on AI as a whole would be imprudent and counterproductive. The proposal of ATIM is to actually empower the ICT, who's supposed to be the agency, okay, the responsible for creating the governance frameworks to make sure that AI is used ethically and responsibly, okay. But if we look at the ICT law, Mr. Congressman, Mr. Chair, okay, walang ganun doon eh. Walang regulatory power on the ICT, okay. And they don't even have the mandate to actually do research, like setting up regulatory sandboxes para maintindihan natin kung saan papunta yung AI, okay, in the current wording of the law. Now, secondly, in the case of data privacy, which Congressman Roman Romano actually was offered, okay, I think there's a need to amend that to make sure that we set up a flexible and agile privacy regulatory framework para kahit anong pumasok na emerging technology dyan, radio at ang ating national privacy. Yun lang po, Mr.
Why not incorporate it in the proposed measure? Because
okay,
ready na tayo. Because yun ang point ni Honorable Barbas and the other authors, ayaw naman natin na only at that point in time when we start discussing a bill such as this, hindi ba pwede mag-incorporate yung suggestions mo dito sa current measures proposed?
Pwede rin, Mr. Chair, Mr. Congressman, okay. But ang hiling lang namin dito is actually to put, to make AIDA be an agency under the purview of the ICT.
Yes,
Mr. Chair.
Congressman, obviously before I recognize you, I'd like to recognize the presence of our Vice Chair, Congressman Chino Almario, our Senior Deputy Minority Leader, Paul Dada, and Congresswoman Franz Pastor. Congresswoman Robles, if you allow me, I'll recognize Vincent Almeron first because I think he wanted to react to the proposal of Mr. Ibrahim right after me. Yes, you said that, Your
Honor. Mr. Chair, actually, in terms of the emerging technology, under Section 6, paragraph of the RA 10844, under Section 6, it says here, it's true that there's no regulation power yet given to the ICT, but there's a policy and planning currently, Mr. Chair. It says there that to formulate, recommend, implement national policies, plans, programs, and guidelines that will promote the development and use of ICT with due consideration to the advantages of convergence and emerging technology. So the word emerging technology, Mr. Chair, there are five emerging technology on that particular level. First, Mr. Chair, is the Internet of Things, IoT. Second is artificial intelligence. Third is blockchain. Fourth is actually cybersecurity. Fifth is the 5G technology. So these are the five emerging technology. The reason why they put in the word emerging technology is because in the actual situation now, there are still, as mentioned by Mr. Mon Ibrahim, that's not yet final. So there are analysis or there are, kumbaga, is pinag-uusapan po natin po yung parang futuristic point of view. That's why it's called emerging technology. So since it's already stated that under the RA 10844, our humble recommendation, Mr. Chair, and also part of our position paper, is if we're going to have that authority, we will be having another authority again later on for IoT, another for 5G, another for other like blockchain and so on and so forth. Since it's already part of the of that law, our humble recommendation as a chair is to have a bureau instead of authority under the ICT. So take note, under the ICT, we have a bureau called Government Digital Transformation Bureau. So clearly, this is more on the software side. And take note that even if you ask AI itself, I actually checked AI, and I asked, define artificial intelligence. So AI itself defined AI as a computer science perspective. So meaning, take note that DOST before, if you remember po, before the creation of the ICT, nanggaling po ito sa dalawang ahensya. Si DOST, meron pong information technology component that time, si DOST. Pangalawa is DOTC, sa Department of Transportation and Communication. Yun pong information technology, kinuha po yan kay DOST, at kinuha rin po yung communication kay DOTC, kaya naging DOTR na lang po siya ngayon, pinag-combine po yan, kaya pinanganak po ang DICT. So, AI po is an information technology. So, it's actually an ICT agenda. So, part of our recommendation, Mr. Chair, our recommendation is instead of creating a certain authority, it might stop the current provisions of the Republic Act 10844, and it's very timely, as I said a while ago, but I think tama po yun na baka po kailangan po talaga madagdagan din po ng power si the ICT to create a bureau that could have that authority na may kasama na po siyang regulation, kasi currently po is policy lang po siyang planning for the moment, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chair. I would just like to amend with the statement of Isaac David Almirol, because as far as I know, FIGI will gonna come up with a bureau under the DICT, since it's all algorithms and it's not for both things, so it's not under DOST. Just correct me if I'm wrong. I just wanted to come up with that bureau also. So this is just a manifestation of what you said a while ago. And also would like to make one manifestation with all the statement of Mr. Ibrahim, no? So medyo mas marami siyang alam na pwede natin isama sa technical working group. So again, Mr. Chair, yun lamang po, sana po yung more of the ICT tayo, not the OST, kasi hindi naman the robotics. Kasi niniisip ng artificial intelligence, karamihan ng iba, na misquote or parang mali ang pagkaintindihan, baka akala ng artificial intelligence ay more of robotics. And hindi rin naman talaga mawawala ng trabaho dahil kamukha ng mga doktor. Kahit may robotics sa ospital, doktor pa rin naman at residente ang kumakawa. So, the Bureau suggested under TICT, Mr. Chair.
Yes, thank you for your comments,
Mr. Chair. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Ibrahim, I'd like to ask a few questions just to at least get everyone on the same page. The first is, could you define how broad AI, its applications, and the nature of AI is in the current technologies that we have today?
But anyway, would you like to comment?
Yeah. Actually, anyone can comment, even if DSCP also wants to.
Sir? General Potasio po, ang tanong po ninyo ay kung gusto makita maunawaan po yung AI, may 1 minute ADP po kami ba kasi yung tignan? Pwede namin claim.
Pwede din?
Pero
again, the question is to define, or at least to help everyone understand how broad AI is. Kasi ang daming applications eh. So,
ako po, makikita doon.
Sige po.
Pwede yan, ma'am, step, pwede yung mag-claim.
Yes.
Sample lang ba? Downloadable na sa social media.